Kaniki, who are representing you. Ladies and gentlemen, Shabbir, Salam, Adab, Namaste. The topic is very thorny. The topic is very controversial. While this organization under which this program is being organized, that is having quest for chintan and solution.
मेरा आपसे अनुरोध है, पीछे आप लोग बैठ जाए कृपया। मैंने आपसे कहा हमारे बीच बहुत बड़े बड़े विद्वान हैं, अगर आप थोड़ा सा अगर आप नहीं सुनना चाहते तो आप कृपया बाहर चले जाएं, लेकिन यहाँ बैठे तो कम से कम सुने और तन से नहीं मन से भी रहें, जैसा कि दीपांकर जी ने कहा था।
थैंक यू। सो आई थिंक इन इंट्रोडक्टरी रिमार्क्स मोस्ट रिवर्ड एंड प्रोफाउंड इज कॉल्ड Indraji has explained in gamut whole matter where controversy lies and where truth lies. What should be the ways that should be adopted by the government, by the public. Since matter is sub judice, matter is before Honorable Supreme Court. So I think sane opinion representing the lawyering may be endorsing this view that on such issue there shouldn't be a public discussion by which the judiciary mind is bound to be affected otherwise. But I am sorry to say, being a student of law, this is my confirmed view which I am sharing. But last for 3 years particularly, I am noticing through the media, I am noticing through the public platform, people are not getting this aspect, and even things are going on, emotionalizing public, even making the public not believe in truth, and rather prevalence of emotion that is being educated. This is wrong tradition. I think it should be checked. Since I am invited here by most revered scholar Indraji and Gopal Bihari Sahib, respecting their sentiment, I am here because cause is very noble. I would share under Article 134 of the Constitution of India directs the Supreme Court, if any matter is as a matter of appeal is pending or rather filed before the Honorable Supreme Court, under this article Supreme Court is duty bound to adjudicate the matter according to the existing rule of law. But in this case what happened, when Honorable Allahabad High Court gave the verdict, matter was something which was raised before Honorable Allahabad High Court, but Allahabad High Court decided this matter as a partition suit, giving equal entitlement to three parties, and virtually that was not prayed. And on this issue, Honorable Supreme Court made observation, it is strange that was not requested before Honorable Allahabad High Court, even crossing the jurisdiction, talked about the partition and gave whole land into three parts. This is the mockery of the situation. And when this matter was accepted by Honorable Supreme Court for hearing, noticing its ticklish, noticing its faith aspect, and noticing its just complexities, Chief Justice Farmer even offered parties for negotiated agreement, and even Supreme Court Chief Justice himself offered to be even one of the facilitator of that very negotiation. So now you can very well understand how this matter is important. Just emotionalizing the audience, saying something which is having no reality, no truth, taking into account the rule of law, taking into account the constitutionality of the matter, rejecting the history, and talking in terms of something which cannot be comprehended from justice point of view. You start from that very history that how the journal of Baba Paki constructed the mosque and onward when any matter was there, unfortunately, DM of Faizabad, any administrative authority, any judicial authority, never took up the matter to decide from the entitlement point of view, rather shifting the matter, taking into account as a law and order problem. And just linger on, matter was piling up, and even very great leaders, including Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Gobind Pant, Chief Minister, and so many political, social, scholarly personality, they have been involved. But no solution of a tangible nature, having perpetuation, having acceptability of the people, and now matter troubled and like anything, and now it is before the Supreme Court. Yes, I agree. I endorse Revered Indiresh Kumar's suggestion, and that is very truthful. If you go to foreign land, I remained in Malaysia serving International Islamic University long for 7 years. And from there, when I was experiencing our motherland, that is India, then I was experiencing every time how much Hindu population, being Indian, they are getting the respect in international milieu. Then I was understanding the beauty of patriotism, beauty of statesmanship, and realizing the might of India. It is 100% correct. Every community on this globe, including Muslims, they are having their separate place, representing their religion, representing their culture, and separate place for worship. For Muslim, Makkah, Medina. Yes, I endorse Honorable Indrajit. Regarding the Christian, Vatican, that is there. Regarding the Jews, that is there. Regarding other communities, that is there. And Hindus, who are constituting a dominant community in India, rather number one, and in terms of their religious identified place for the purpose of worship, representing their religion and culture, there must be a place and there should be identified. And what is that place other than Ayodhya? Yes, it is well accepted fact, and on this premises, this is, should be propounded and it should be explored. And for that purpose, I would share an international milieu, and that is the matter of Palestinian. I may tell you, J.B. Carter and Anwar Sadat, and this agreement is known Camp David Agreement. 11 days they sat together, negotiated, and concluded. And what was the conclusion? This should be the lesson for this worthy audience and those who are the custodian of the religion and culture and religiosity of a particular Hindu community. And I am advocating in favor of Hindu community. What is that? Decision was there. West Jerusalem belongs to Arab, where Masjid Aqsa is situated. And East Jerusalem belongs to Jews. And by that negotiated settlement, this matter was solved, and still that situation is existing. Not only that, I will be giving you another example. Very pious. My very sir. Another point I may be telling you, Hazrat Umar bin Aziz, it is the matter of Damisk, and his one Sipeh Salar even just made a harm to a church, and many portion of the church that were destroyed and added with the existing mosque. When it came to his notice, he got destroyed that additional matter, and given to the Christian community. So it doesn't mean that it is now adjacent to the mosque, so it is the part of the mosque and it cannot be given to anybody like that. It is not like that. History is full of that. So in that way, another situation I will be telling you, Church and Juma Masjid, Istanbul, Turkey. What situation is there? Even today, both communities side by side, they are performing their ritual and rites. In that way, lot of examples that can be given there. And here, sir, as a matter of solution, though it may be very hard to the Muslim community, quite possible it may be opposed by Hindu community. But this is my conscience, and this is my very deep research. And out of that, when diversities, they are having constitutional existence, they are there, live and let live formula should remain there, and every community should get the satisfaction in that very way. So before this august audience, and with the permission of Shri Indresh ji, I will be proposing that in Ayodhya, there must be, I am not saying should, because it is a matter of my conviction, there should be Lord Rama Masjid and there should be Lord Rama Mandir. And here, it should not be taken. It shouldn't be taken otherwise, because according to my belief and conviction, Lord Rama is one of the paigambar about whom Muslims they believe. Lord Krishna is one of the paigambars about whom Muslims they are believing. And according to the historical records, sir, there are 1,24,000 paigambars. In that legacy, in totality, Lord Rama Purushottam is our paigambar. Lord Krishna is our paigambar. And like a paigambar, like a chief paigambar of Hindu community, they should give the due respect, due reverence, and out of that Muslim community, I think, should come forward. But I may tell you, sir, and that is the last. There is no judicial solution. I may tell you, by virtue of Supreme Court judgment, either Muslims they are going to win the case, or Hindus they are going to win the case. But that is not bringing a perpetual solution, sir. Reaction will be there, civil war will be there, and so many destruction will take place. Political matter needs political solution. This is a matter of faith. People should have negotiation, good sense should prevail, and tolerance, respect to each other as a permanent citizenry of India. They should have negotiated settlement, and Muslim they should come forward. Yes, there should be the constructed Ram, Lord Rama Masjid, there should be constructed Lord Rama Mandir. I think, sir, that will give the satisfaction if it is really negotiated to the Hindus also, to the Muslim also, and then, sir, peace, development, tranquility, and Jagat Guru of Hindu, due to the might of this our country, due to might of Adatwai, and now our India is 8th most powerful country. And sir, from SAC, I am happy to share with this with the audience. In UN, sir, a negotiation is going to take place that our India should get a place in Security Council having a permanent vetoship and veto power. And there, sir, I am nominated to negotiate the matter in the UN. So, might of India should remain a perpetual. It should go high and high. Not only Ram Janm Bhoomi or Ram Janm Sthan is very important, as everybody is acknowledging. Its solution, acceptable solution, on that intelligentsia, which is under the leadership, under the intellectual, and rather scholarship, River Indresh, that is going on, reach some conclusion, and I think negotiation and negotiation, that will bring the result. Thank you very much.